Hi guys, welcome back to Bodoyibo TV. It's your girl Bridget Akpo. Yeah, I wanted to have a chat with you guys about something that I put on my Instagram page a while ago. So yeah, if it's your first time, thank you for joining me. Please consider subscribing. Is the red button down there? And if you are already a member of Bodoyibo family, thank you very much for stopping by today. I thank you for all your likes, your comments, and your shares. I appreciate all of you for always coming here to watch my videos. Thank you so much. From the bottom of my heart, I thank you guys. So what I wanted to share with you guys today is about a request that one of my subscribers sent to me. He said, I don't know if it's a he or she. Could you do a video? And the request says, could you do a video about African parents in the diaspora that emotionally neglect their children because they are too busy taking care of family in Africa and building houses? That's talking about African parents who in the diaspora who are too busy and they neglect their children as a result of their busy lifestyle, and you know, as a result the children are neglected emotionally and because they are busy basically and working, which is what most of us do over here, is work, look for money, try to make our lives better, you know, and to help people back home as well. But what this person, the contention they had was the fact that a lot of African parents are neglecting their children because all they care about is the money they are making, and all they do is work, and they're emotionally neglecting their children as a result. I mean, I just posted this comment on my Instagram page, and the response I got was overwhelming. A lot of people, I was surprised. I didn't know. I mean, I know it's an issue, and I wanted to talk about it because I usually try to look at the requests that I get to determine, you know, if I want to talk about it or not. I mean, I know it's an issue, and I was planning to talk about it, but I just wanted to see the response of other people out there. So I put it on my, I just took a shot of it, and I put it on my Instagram page. And you should see the response. It was overwhelming. Ladies inboxed me and said they were telling me the impact this has had on their lives. One particular one was saying how it's difficult for her to form relationships. You know, she has trust issues because of the fact that while they were growing up, she and her sister, you know, they were severely neglected by their parents because all they were doing was working. And you know, building a life in Africa while they were living here. I mean, the issue of house, you guys, I mean, some of you who've been my subscribers for a while know that it's something that we've talked about a lot on this channel. I really don't want to dwell on it because I feel like we've overflowed that issue, and people will do what they want to do. I mean, it's fine. We are all adults and we can make our own decisions. So I don't want to really talk about the issue of house because I feel like we've overflowed it. And the last video that I did talking about houses or building a house, the conclusion, you know, that I arrived at based on the interaction that I've had with people, several people on my channel, was the fact that somebody said, gave the suggestion that yeah, if you are retiring, wherever you are retiring to, might be the best place that you want to build or you want to buy. Or if you don't want to build at the moment, you feel like you don't have trust for, or you don't have people that you can trust, then maybe when you're ready to go, you can sell up here in the diaspora and then you go and build. I don't know. People have different ideas about this issue of building houses. And what I found is that people will do what they want to do. So, I mean, that's just what it is. It is what it is. So I'm not going to dwell about on the issue of building. What I really want to talk about is the issue of neglect. Because as a social worker, I know the impact that neglect, emotional neglect, has on children. When we talk about abuse, people often think that it's only physical abuse, which is beating or injuring somebody by, you know, physical chastisement or hitting somebody or hitting a child. That is the only kind of abuse that exists. Or if it's sexual abuse, no, there are other kind of abuse. As a matter of fact, emotional abuse is one that goes very, very deep because the wounds are not physical. You can't see the wounds that is inflicting on the child, but it's something that the child will probably have to live with for the rest of their lives. And it takes a long time to heal from emotional abuse. Most parents might not know, you know, but emotional abuse is real and it affects children. It affects them a lot. It won't just only affect them when they are children and they are young. It will also carry on when they are adults. It will affect them in terms of how they are able to form relationships and their lives as adults, how they will be successful in bonding with other people or building relationships or trust and things like that. It has a whole lot of psychological effects that it has, emotional abuse. So I don't know, what am I going to say about it? There's so much to say about it, but it's a two-way street. That's the way I see it. First of all, we come here, most of us who come abroad come here to make a better life for ourselves and our families. And while we're here, we don't always, only look after ourselves and our immediate family. We also have to think about our family back home, because a lot of people will come from very poor background and they have aged parents who are depending on them, or brothers and sisters, you know, extended family who are depending on them. So, I can't say don't send money home or don't help anybody. It's just not possible. You can't. Even if you don't want to do it, the need is so much. That's why I said to people all the time, so even if you don't want to do it, the need is so much. Somebody will just call you. They'll be crying on the phone. They've not eaten. How can you turn your back on somebody that has not eaten? Somebody says, since yesterday, I have not eaten. We are talking about primary needs that people have. We are not talking about luxury, buying luxury items. We are talking about people's primary needs, like food, like shelter, you know, paying school children's fees. So many things that people primarily need to survive. This is what we're talking about. So when somebody comes to you and say, for instance, I have not eaten since 2 days, or I've not eaten since yesterday, and you know, I know in some cases some people might, you know, make it up, but there are genuine cases where these things are happening because of the poverty and lack. There are some people that will go a whole day, they will not have even food to eat. What, you know, people who live in diaspora take for granted. That's just the way it is. So, if you come from such families, or you know people like that, you have such connections back home, you can't turn your back on people. You can't say, oh, your conscience will not allow you. Except you are somebody without a conscience, you cannot do it. It's not possible. You always have to want to try your, no matter how small, your minimum best, if it's £20, $100, $50, or £100, £50, €50, €100, you want to send at least. Even if you cannot do it every day, you want to, you know, do it when the need, or, you know, when the need is really pressing. Or, you, for instance, you hear that your relative is in the hospital, they are sick, you can't turn your back, you have to send. So I can't just say that, you know, parents, I can't just, you know, castigate parents and say, oh, why are you doing this? Why are you neglecting your children? Neglect is not good. I can't just say, why are you working? Let me put it that way. I can't just say, why are you working so hard? Why are you working so hard that you are sending money, and your children are suffering? But at the end of the day, as parents, we are responsible for our own children. So we need to balance it. That's all I will say. We need to balance. We all have very, very busy lifestyle. We have jobs, we have commitments, both here and back home. But any parent who cares about the well-being of their children, if you care about the well-being of your children, you have to balance it, because emotional development is very important for children, especially very young children. I told you guys the story of when we came and somebody was telling me that I should go and give my child to a minder outside London. Some women don't have any qualms doing that. Some families don't have any qualms doing that. In fact, I used to know a child minder in London. She's been deported to Nigeria now. This woman was not a registered child minder. She was just somebody who doesn't have papers. So she was working. She wasn't working. She used to sew. She sewed clothes. So she was renting this apartment. And you should see the number of children that this woman was caring for. People will just come and dump their children there, and the children will be there all week. She will be the one that will be taking the children to school, the ones that went to school. Most of them had not started school. They are babies. So she will be the one. And she used to sew for me. That's how I got to know her. She used to sew for me. It's been a while now. And whenever I go there, I will just see children. You're unkept, untidy. You know, the house is a mess. Because she's not cooking only. She's catering as well. She does cooking. So she will be cooking. You will see how she's cooking these bags and bags of rice that she's cooking for people who are doing party. She's sewing. Then she's minding children. Just tell me, how is it possible? It's not like she has anybody that is working for her. How is it possible for one person to be doing catering, you'll be cooking at the same time, simultaneously, you have clothes that you are sewing for people, and then you have children. I'm talking about these children at a point. She will have like maybe 6-7 children that she's minding, all below maybe 5, from 5 downwards. How is it possible? We all know that it's not possible. Invariably, there's going to be issues of neglect around there, because you see some of the children, they've not taken their bath. Some of them, you don't even know what they are feeding them, you know. I don't know how parents can do that. Me personally, I can't do it all, because my children are my life. I cannot. As a woman that went through pregnancy, I carried my baby in my womb for 9 months and I went through that pain of labor. I cannot leave my child for anybody. It's only now that my children are grown that I can travel, because I know that they can take care of themselves. You know, my husband is at home and my daughter is there. And, you know, so they are old enough to manage without me when I travel briefly. So that's when I wouldn't worry. But I cannot carry my children to go and give one childminder to be looking after for weeks. Or the one that we heard recently in London, that some women will leave their children and travel. They will leave their children at home and travel and tell their neighbor to keep an eye on the child. That is definitely abuse. You know that's abuse. How are you going to leave children alone in their flats, in your flat, and then you travel and go to Nigeria, and then you say, oh, my neighbor, keep an eye on them for me. What if anything happens today? I don't know. Some people, you know, they say that it's not every woman that is maternal. Honestly, some women have babies, but they are not maternal. Because if anybody that knows will know that there's an attachment that you build with children, and there's a certain age for which you can do that attachment. It's called attachment theory. Those of you who are psychiatrists or psychologists will know about it. Social workers will also know about it, because we are taught about it. The period of that attachment is the period that where the primary caregiver has to form an attachment with that child. If you don't form that attachment with that child at that period, once it passes, that child will struggle to form attachment. It will take the grace of God for them to be able to form attachment throughout their life. They will struggle. And if they are not able to form attachment, it's going to affect their relationship. They will not be able to build relationship. They will not be able to, because it's going to affect communication. It's going to affect their confidence. It will going to affect their esteem. That's why some children have low self-esteem. They are not confident. Because there's nobody that can look after your child like yourself. Especially mothers. Fathers too, but primarily it's women, it's mothers that are the primary caregivers in most homes, because fathers are always working, or you know, they are not available, or maybe it's a single parent home or something like that. Women are always the primary caregivers. So for mothers, it's very, very important that you form that attachment with your child. How do you form that attachment? Is that child interacting with that child? It doesn't mean that you're just going to be spoiling them or cuddling them every day, all day. No. You raise them the way, you correct them when they do something wrong, but you build that bond. There's a bond that you build with those children that bond is so strong that it will give the child confidence in the world, because you'll be telling them every day. If you see that, like for instance, some children don't have much confidence, but if you are noticing it as a parent, as they are growing, you begin to notice that trait. And then you have to be boosting their confidence. How do you boost a child's confidence? You give them compliments. If they feel they can't do something, you tell them, oh, you can do it. If anybody can do it, you can do it. You praise them. You know, if you continue to praise a child, or you continue to tell them positive things about themselves, they will believe it. And it's the opposite for the negative as well. When you continue to tell a child something negative about themselves, that's why children who suffer from very severe emotional abuse, they've been abused in such a way that their parent or whoever they're living with would have been telling them over time that they are useless, they are good for nothing, they cannot amount to anything, they cannot be useful in life. After a while, they will believe it. And once a child believes something like that, it would take a lot of work and prayers to break that circle, because they've been brought up to believe, you know, this is who they are. That's why it's very, very important for you as a parent to ensure that you do not neglect your children emotionally, please. I'm begging you parents out there, if you're a mom out there, money is important, but money is not everything. I say it all the time. Those children, there's a time that you need to focus on them. Those of you that are doing double shift, triple shift, and all you do is work, you leave your children, you don't even know. You don't even know what they are doing. You don't know who their friends are. You don't know who they are talking to. They are on their iPad and their phones all the time. You don't need me. I encourage my children, bring your friends home. I know all my friends, my children, I know their friends. They will come to the house. I see them, I assess them. Some of them, I know their parents. In fact, some of them, for the younger ones, I've become friends with their parents. I've become friends with their parents through the children. Because that is the way you know your child. That is where you know who they are dealing with. You don't know. When they go to school, you don't know who they are talking to. You don't know who they are relating with. And children can be very secretive, especially if they are already having issues at home, that they feel like their parent is not paying attention to them. That it's all about work, and sending money to home to Nigeria, or, you know, looking after relatives. some mothers or some families, some parents will neglect their children. They will be taking care of their families back home in Africa at the expense of their children. I don't understand it. Even the Bible says you love your neighbor as yourself. It didn't say love your neighbor more than yourself. So I don't understand how you can love your sister's child, or you love your distant relative child more than your own children. You might feel like, okay, you are teaching them a lesson. Oh, but there you go, children. I know we say it all the time that they are spoiled, they should learn. But you cannot neglect your children like that. These are your children, they're your future. So I don't want to drag it. I just want to put it out there. For those of us who are parents, please. There's a time that you need to focus on your children. Ensure that you are building them emotionally. Let them be very, very emotionally, as much as possible, resilient and strong, and able to defend themselves, able to stand. Some children cannot communicate. When they go out, they cannot communicate. They will just be quiet. It's not a good thing when your child cannot communicate. It doesn't mean that, oh, they are so good, they are wonderful, they have good behavior. No. Sometimes when they cannot communicate, you don't even know what is in their heart. So if you notice that trait when you are with your child and you are noticing that they cannot communicate, you help them to build confidence in communication. You know, you draw them out gradually. You draw them out gradually and you work with them as a parent, because there's nobody that knows your child more than you. But some parents don't know their children, unfortunately. Some parents don't. Some African parents neglect their children emotionally, and that is what this young girl was telling me, you know, on Instagram. Was saying, auntie, please, it affected me and my sister. This is a young lady telling me, say, auntie, it affected me and my sister so much. Our parents did not show us any care. They neglected us. All they were doing was working and sending money to Africa. Even now, we've tried to tell them how we feel, you know, the impact of what they've done, but you know, they are not listening. They're not even buying it. They feel like maybe we are seeking attention seekers, or you know, they don't take us seriously. That's not good. Let's try and focus on our children while they are developing. Those years, those first 10 years of their lives is vital. Please, their development is very, very important. Let's focus on our children. Let's work. And put, both of you cannot be working 24 hours. When one person is working, who are you leaving the children for? Focus on your children. The time will come when the children will grow. I'm not saying don't work, but this balancing, you need to balance it in a way that the times that you're away from your children is not too much, especially between that age of 0 to 10 years. It's very, very primary that, you know, it's very, very vital that a parent, especially as a mom, that you are there for your child. It's very, very important. So guys, I'm just going to leave this here. I hope you found this very useful today. Leave me a comment down below in the comment section. If you haven't subscribed, be sure to hit on the subscribe button. And yeah, join the conversation in the comment section. And I shall see you guys in my next one. Thank you very much for watching. I love you. Bye-bye. We believe in God the Father. We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe in the Holy Spirit.